Hi everyone, exciting news. I recently got an email that read, "Hi Jeff, first of all, I want to say that I really like your video on painting minis, Mice and Mystics, Zombicide, Kingdom Death. I appreciate your passion for creating great videos, but most importantly, I appreciate the effort and time you spend to edit a video to perfect it for your audience, and all those hours in front of a computer. As an influencer who can attest to the importance of having a good desk setup, we would like to offer you an Arthrodesk ErgoSpring standing desk converter for free, shipping included. All we ask is for a video review of our product on your YouTube channel. Please let us know if you are interested and we can talk further about partnering. Margaret." First of all, I thought it was great that Margaret specifically mentioned the name of one of my videos in her email, which has definitely convinced me that she watched it. Secondly, I immediately wrote back and said I'd love to do a video review for the desk. Margaret sent me her terms and I agreed to the partnership. I was really looking forward to this. For years, I've always had to play my board games on this dumb, normal table. I've known that many companies make tables designed specifically for gaming, but never thought I'd ever get the chance to own one. So, you can imagine my excitement when I got this in the mail. It's sturdy, slick, and made of top quality particle board. I eagerly spent the past few days trying it out with a ton of different games, but unfortunately, I'm sad to report that this is potentially the worst board game product I've ever seen. To start, you're supposed to put game boards on the top part of the desk. However, it's so narrow that 90% of the games I own don't even fit on it. The boards end up hanging over the side where they lack support and become easy to bump into. It's just plain bad design. There is this nifty card holder up here, but unfortunately, it's placed right smack dab in the middle where the board would normally go. It's basically impossible to lay out a board and store your cards at the same time. On top of that, the desk only includes one card holder. I don't know if Arthrodesk designed this with only solo gamers in mind, but if you're ever playing a game with another person, they'll be forced to hold their cards in the old-fashioned, inconvenient way. Now, the bottom section of the desk is actually pretty cool. It provides an area for you to store your personal components where they won't get in the way of the game board. However, the bottom section is only present on one side of the desk. If someone is sitting across from you, there's literally no space for them to store anything. Buying this desk basically restricts you to only playing two-player games, and even then, you have to sit next to each other, making things cramped and uncomfortable pretty quickly. Now, if all that isn't enough, the stupidest thing of all has got to be the standing feature. If you reach into this hole and squeeze the lever, the entire thing lifts up. When you do this, it makes it completely impossible to see anything on the desk, and you're forced to just sit there like an idiot. You then have to play the rest of the game guessing what the board looks like and hoping you use the correct components. It's truly psychotic. Even worse, when rolling dice, it's really easy for them to fall into one of these holes, which means you're constantly having to pick them up off the floor. To top it all off, there are all these weird bars on the underside, which means the space under the desk is impossible to utilize. It's an engineering failure and makes no sense whatsoever. All in all, this product is very terrible, and I really hate it. Maybe I'd like it if I was a big idiot or some kind of bonehead, but as it stands, I'm not, and it stinks. Honestly, I can't think of a single person I'd recommend this to, and ultimately, I'm embarrassed that Arthrodesk is a company that continues to exist. I sincerely hope that they go out of business and their factory gets destroyed in a way that can't be repaired.